exclusion is the one most common method to produce plastic. Plastic exclusion is compression process in which material is forced to flow through a die or device to provide non-continuous product whose cross-sectional shape is determined by the shape of the orifice or die. This is the figure for the plastic exclusion. For plastic exclusion, it contains two main components of an excluder. For the first one is barrier and the second one is glue. As the die, it is not act as an excluder component. For an excluder screw, it can be divided into three divided sections. The first one is fixed section, and the second one is compression section, and the third one is metering section. For the fixed section, it used to preheat the fixed stock and move it from hopper. And the second section is compression section, and we think of as melting zone. It transforms the polymer into free air mixed with plastic pellet that extracted from melt and then compress the material. For the third section, metering section is also known as melt pumping zone. The melt is homogenized and sufficient pressure developed to the pump it through a die opening. This is the fixed zone, and this is the melting zone, and this is melt pumping zone. And this is the figure shows the component of excluder. The first one, barrier and screw. The step to plastic exclusion. First step, fit wrong plastic is fit into hopper and then fit down into excluder. The bread flow from hopper down onto a large spinning screw within a horizontal barrier. And then bread is then heated to melting temperature of the type of the plastic used, then pass through the barrier and mix truly at the end of the screw. The step 4 is the excluded plastic flow across a screen and a breaker. The screen is used to remove any contaminant or inconsistency in the plastic, and the breaker is used to change the motion of the plastic from rotational to longitudinal. The last step is die. Die is designed so that the plastic flows smoothly, evenly, and continuously. The benefit of method exclusion is it is low cost, better flexibility, and post exclusion alteration. Compared to other methods to produce plastic, plastic exclusion is more reasonable, price is more reasonable because the leftover material can be refitted, undergoes melting and hardening, and continuous to use. And the better flexibility is the product of the plastic exclusion produces a hard and soft surface, so it can provide a better flexibility of product. For the post exclusion alteration, the plastic remains hot when it leaves the excluder. So it can be alter the shape of the excluded plastic after the product is produced. The disadvantage of plastic is the expansion and product limitation. The expansion occurs because the hot plastic exceeds the excluder and it frequently expands. The expansion of the plastic at this stage is called die swell. For the next one, product limitation, the investment of the plastic exclusion of different type need different equipment, so it cannot produce many shapes of the exclusion product. Well, that's what happened because excluded polymer, remember, is previous shape when in the larger cross section of the extruder, it tries to return to it after leaving the die or orange. For the application for plastic exclusion, solution is it can be made to insulating pad, vibration absorption tube, battery packer, cable duct and cover, window frame, and the last one is vehicle springing. For the material to produce the plastic extrusion is neon, ABS, PVC, elastomer, polyethyl, polystyrene, polycarbonate. The classification of plastic extrusion is sheet extrusion, sheet and firm extrusion, ground firm extrusion, overjecting extrusion, tubing extrusion, core extrusion, extrusion coating, compound extrusion. There are two types of profile for plastic extrusion. There are solid profile and hollow profile. For solid profile, it can be separate to two parts, regular part and irregular part. For regular part can be made as round and square. For irregular part is structural shape, door and windows molding, automobile trim, and house siding. Whereas for the hollow profile, it normally to be used as tube, pipe, hose, and other cross section which contain holes. For the hollow part, normally slider is used to help membrane. The membrane is support into a monolithic tube wall, polymer melt, and flow around the lab. The module often include an air channel through which the air is drawn to maintain hollow form of extruded during hardening. And the last one is wire and cable coating. Polymer melt is applied to bare wire and it is pulled at high speed to a die. A sliding vacuum is drawn between wire and polymer to promote adhesion of coating. Wire provides rigidity during cooling, passing through cold wire to a water tube. This is the figure for the wiring coating. That's all for my part. Thank you.
Now I would like to proceed to my part, which is the polymer sheet and frame. First of all, the thickness of the frame is below 5 mm and it can be made with different resins with unique combination of properties. And it is flexible in nature, which can be used in the grocery bag, soft drink bottle, and butter tube. For the sheet, the thickness is from 0.5 mm to 12.5 mm. The application of frame is food packaging, non-food packaging, and non-packaging application. For food packaging, it can be used for non-frozen bagged goods such as roll or bread. For non-food packaging, it's normally used in the industrial liner, and for non-packaging application, it's used to produce grocery, t-shirt, and trash bags. For the application of sheet, it's widely used in the flat window glazing and thermoforming stock. There are four types of polymer, sheet, and foam, which are polypropylene, polycarbonate, PVC, and also cellophane. The process that include in the sheet and foam are slight dice extrusion of sheet and foam, roll foam extrusion process, and calendaring. For the first one, slight dice extrusion of sheet and foam. The sheet and foam of various thickness are produced by the conventional extrusion by using a fine slit as the dice opening. The slit may be up to 3 meter wide or as narrow as around 0.4 mm. The dice include a manifold that spreads the polymer melt laterally before it flows through the slide. The edge of the foam should trim because of the thickness at the edge. There are some difficulties in this method, which are the uniformity of the thickness throughout the width of the stock. This is caused by the drastic shape change experienced by the polymer melt during its flow through the dice. And below are the figure shows that one of the several dice configurations for extruding sheet and foam. The second method is the raw film extrusion process. This process can be carried out vertically upward. However, the horizontal and downward extrusions process are now become more common. Here are the procedure of raw film extrusion process. First, the polymer method start in a pellet form with a successively compact and melt to form a continuous viscous liquid. And this molten plastic is then forced or extruded through an annular die. Next, the air is injected through a hole in the center of the die and the pressure causes the extrusion melt to expand into a bubble. The air entering the bubble replaces air leaving it, so that even and constant pressure is maintained to ensure the uniform thickness of the film. Then, the bubble is pulled continually upward from the dies and the cooling rings blow air into the film. After the solidification, the film moves into a set of knit laurel which collapse the bubble and flatten it into two flat firm layers. And lastly, the cooler roll pull the film onto pin-up roller and the film pass through the middle roll during this process to ensure that there is a uniform tension of the film. Lastly is the calendaring. Calendaring is a specialty process for high volume, high quality plastic film and sheets, and it is mainly used for PVC. The melt polymer is subject to heat and pressure in an extruded and formed into sheet of film by calendaring roll. The temperature and speed of the roll influence the property of the film, and the calendaring is allowed the specialty surface treatment of the film or sheet, such as embossing or enhancing the physical property or inline lamination. There are some products that can be made by calendaring process, which are PVC floor covering, shower curtains, pore liner, and inflatable boards and toys. Lastly, these are the two figures which illustrate the calendaring machines and calendaring process. Now I would like to proceed to fiber and filament product. A fiber is a long, thin strand whose length is at least 100 times its cross-section, and the filament is a fiber of continuous length. Both fiber and filament consist of bark, chalk fiber and strand, and continuous monofilament of material. The material for fiber and filament are carbon, polymer, glass, cellulose, and other components. The fiber and filament are widely used in reinforcing composite fiber and filament for textile and growing application. Now is the fiber and filament production speeding. A synthetic fiber is a man-made fiber, and most synthetic and cellulosic manufactured fiber are created by extrusion, which is forcing a thick viscous fluid through the tiny hole of a device called spinnerets to form a continuous filament of semi-solid polymer. A spinneret is a device that used to extrude a polymer solution or a polymer melt to form fiber. There are three types of production process which include melt spinning, dry spinning, and wet spinning. For the melt spinning, the fiber forming substance is melt for extrusion through the spinneret and then rapid cooling of liquid. The melt spun fiber can be extruded from the spinneret in different cross-sectional shapes, for example, triangle shape, pentagonal shape, and hollow fiber trap air that creating the insulation and provide loft characteristics equal to or better than down. Next is the dry spinning. The polymer is dissolved in its solvent and then extruded. As the fiber emerges through the spinneret, the solvent is evaporated off with the hot air. This dry spinning is used for fiber forming substance in solution, and the dry spinning technique is used for such kind of polymer which would not melt but degrade on heating.
solid do not come in contact with a precipitating liquid, eliminating the risk for driving and easing solvent recovery. This process may be used for the production of acetate, PVI, and so on. Lastly is the wet spinning. This is the oldest process which used for the polymer that need to be dissolved in the solvent first. The spinnerets are submerged in a chemical bath as the filament emerges the precipitate form solution and solidify. Because of the solution is extruded directly into the precipitating liquid, this process for making fiber is called a wet spinning. And the product of this process can be rayon, aramid, monocrylic, and so on. This is the figure for the three production, which is melt spinning, dry spinning, and wet spinning. That's all from me. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Next, I would like to introduce injection molding process. Injection molding process is a commonly used manufacturing process for plastic part fabrication. And these are the materials that commonly used for injection molding process. The advantages for molding process is that it provides variety of product in terms of size and complexity. Besides that, the product also proved to have good dimensional control and there are good product consistency. The disadvantage, however, is that it involves high initial tooling tools costs and also high machinery costs. Besides that, it is also economical only for large production due to the high cost of the mold. And this is the overview for an injection molding machine. Inside an injection molding machine, there are mainly two principal components, which are the injection unit and also the clamping unit. Inside injection unit, there are four main parts, which are the barrel and also the screw. The barrel is fed by hopper that containing supply of plastic pellet. For the screw, it mixes and hits the polymer and helps inject the molten plastic into the mold. For the clamping unit, it helps to open and close the mold in molding cycle. It also helps to hold two halves of mold in proper alignment. Besides that, it also keeps the mold closed during the injection cycle. The injection molding process is carried out in general four steps. The first one is the clamping process. The second one, injection molding process. The third one, cooling process. And the final one is the injection process. There are several types of mold used in the injection molding process. The first one is two-plate mold. The second one, three-plate mold. And the last one is called random mold. In the injection molding process, there is a problem occur which is called as the shrinkage. The shrinkage is the reduction in linear size during process of mold cooling to room temperature. The shrinkage is occur due to the thermal expansion coefficient of polymers. And these are the few types of shrinkage factor. There are also another injection molding process which involve thermoset. They are called as the compression molding. The advantage of compression molding is that the products are stronger and stiffer, they are lighter, more resistant to corrosion, and complex parts can be cracked. And this is the illustration of a compression molding process. The next one is transfer molding process. In transfer molding process, there are two types of variation. The first one is pot transfer molding, and the second one is tunnel transfer molding. And this is the illustration of a pot transfer molding process. And this is for tunnel transfer molding process. Next, I'm going to introduce you into the blow molding process. For blow molding process, the parts that can be made are like bottles, piping, tubing, and also containers. And this is the common material used for blow molding process. The methods used in blow molding process are extrusion blow molding, injection blow molding, and also stretch blow molding. All of the blow molding process are generally run in two steps. The first one is the fabrication of starting tube of molten plastic, which also known as the parison. Step 2 is the inflation of tip to a desired final shape. And this is the illustration. filtration for extrusion blown molding process. And this is for the injection molding process. The third one is the stretch blown molding process, in which you can see in the final product will be stretched in order to form the final production. Next, I'm going to pass to my next next group member. Thank you.
Now I will proceed to the thermal forming process. Thermal forming process is a process that where a plastic sheet or film is heated to a pliable forming temperature and formed to a specific shape in a mold. Usually, thermal forming is heating accomplished by a radiant electric heater located on one side or both sides of the starting plastic sheet or film. Thermal forming process is widely used in the packaging of the product and to fabricate large items such as bathtub control, skylight, and the internal door liner for the refrigerator. This is several types of thermal forming process. First is the vacuum thermal forming, then followed by mechanical thermal forming, and also the pressure thermal forming process. Then this is a vacuum term for vacuum thermal forming process. The vacuum forming tool is put in the vacuum forming machine and to be warm. Then the plastic material in the roll or sheet form is put to the vacuum forming machine material carrier. Then the heater located above the sheet will heat the sheet of vacuum forming material until it becomes softened. After that, the auto leveling device then support the softened sheet of vacuum forming material with air. Then the tool is raised to meet the bottom surface of the sheet of material, and a vacuum air is to apply in order to draw the sheet over the shape of the vacuum forming tool. Then the auto leveling device then support the softened sheet of the vacuum forming material with air. Then the tool is raised to meet the bottom surface of the sheet of the material, and a vacuum of air is applied in order to draw the sheet over the shape of the vacuum forming tool. Then we will see how the mechanical thermal forming works. The thermoplastic sheet is preheat by means of direct mechanical force. Then the core plug positive mold will force the soft sheet to fill the space between the plug and also the negative mold. The process provides the precise dimensional tolerance and the surface detailing. While for the pressure thermal forming, the process involves a shaping of a preheat thermoplastic sheet by the means of air pressure. The air pressure will force the soft sheet to deform in conformity with the cavity shape. Then when the plastic comes into the contact with the mold surface, it will cool down and become hardened. Now, for the material that is suitable for the thermal forming process is there will be only thermal plastic that can be thermal formed. While for the extrusion sheet or thermal setting or elastometric polymer has already closed link and they cannot be softened and by heating, and it is not suitable as the material for the thermal forming. The example for the material for thermal forming is polypropylene, polystyrene, polyvinyl chloride, and low density polyethylene, high density polyethylene, and also cellulose acetate. That is the advantage and the disadvantage of thermal forming. The advantage of thermal forming is it is required low temperature and it has a fast mold cycle and there is very low pressure required. The product that produced by thermal forming are light in weight and also durable. But for this advantage is thermal forming cannot be produced the product that is have a very complex shape. And after a thermal forming process, the trimming is required to cut the excessive part of the thermal forming. limited amount of spread since the trimming process is required. That's all from me.
At the end, there is some design guidelines that need to be followed in the plastic manufacturing.
For general, the strength and the stiffness, impact resistance, surface temperatures, thermal expansions. For extrusions, the wall thickness, hollow sections, and the corners. For the moldings, the reinforcing bricks, holes, wall thickness, corner radius, and fillets.
That's all for our presentation of our group. Thank you.